Hey everybody, today we're back talking respiratory muscles, secondary respiratory muscles, and primary respiratory muscles. I'm alone here with my buddy, but he still has his mask on. So, right, a lot of places have to wear masks right now. And we're definitely not gonna get into our beliefs, should you not, different states, different regulations. That's not the point. That's all I keep hearing about. So I wanted to come at you today and help educate you on what possibly could be happening if you feel restricted or like you're not getting enough airflow through your mask. And of course, more importantly, because we talk strength training, how does that affect your lifting potentially? Because I have seen some unique changes with these on. Now, I have to highlight, it's not just a mask, right? It could be a painter's respirator when you're working outside in the sun. It may make you feel like you're restricted. Maybe you're wearing a respirator while going through Walmart or training. We also have, before this was a mask mandate, those amazing elevation masks. And I was gonna bring mine in. I had version one that was the full gas mask with the eye lights and the little hole to straw to breathe through. And I have a lot of training time actually using that in real life experience. Now, I don't have a way to gauge, is there more oxygen or less oxygen coming through this mask? I don't have a way to gauge, is it restricted airflow? Just like I don't have the tools to gauge, did those respiratory masks really work or not for increasing oxygen or depriving oxygen coming into the body? However, I can help educate you a little bit on respiratory muscles and that fight or flight response. So, I can tell you, if you feel like you're getting less airflow through here, whether there's more oxygen or not, if you feel restricted and you start to have that panic moment, we are gonna go into that fight or flight response. Adrenaline's released in the body, heart starts beating faster, blood pressure raises, that takes us down to breathe faster and shallower, trying to get more oxygen in. Those things are not good for weightlifting. That might be a natural response for running sprints, right? Maybe not the best trained breathing mechanics for running sprints, but it happens. So, our primary respiratory muscles are the diaphragm and the intercostals, right? That is what is supposed to do most of our breathing. Now, if we have a restricted rib cage, if we're stressed out about work already, and we're used to breathing up through here, these may not be functioning well. When that happens, or a huge adrenaline dump and that fight or flight response happens, our secondary respiratory muscles come in. Pec minor, scalenes, SCM, upper trap muscles, and levator scapula, just to name a few. If you're not really familiar with your anatomy, that's this area. What happens when that goes wrong and we start breathing with these secondary respiratory muscles, not necessarily goes wrong, but takes in and assists, we start to elevate our rib cage up, our scapula up, even our collarbone, and it can roll into an anterior tilt in the shoulder. If you followed us for long enough, you probably know those are not good things when you're lifting. I've talked extensively, one of my pet peeves, watching athletes squat with a bar and bringing it up and down. Anytime we have respiratory breathing and our shoulder comes forward, that's gonna be a disaster in our bench press. Both of those could lead to potential injuries. Now, if we're in the gym, again, it's hot out, we're mandated to wear a mask, or we're just having a hard time breathing, and we start to get shallow breaths, short of breath, and we feel like we panic and we can't get enough air in. That's the biggest thing I personally learned from wearing one of the hard to breathe through elevation masks, was learning to stay calm as a fighter and control my breathing. Because as soon as I panicked and went, I couldn't get as much air in, and it got worse and I would have to pull the thing off. If I could stay calm, get rid of some of that fight or flight response, slow my heart rate, drop my blood pressure a little bit, I could start to get fuller breaths and feel like I could keep that training mask on. Now back to lifting, of course, when I'm with my buddy and that rib cage starts expanding up, trying to pull through here, we talked about this with a squat, look what happens to his back, right? It's deviating from position. And that could be true even for a bench press. If I lay down and I'm not braced well and I feel panicked and I start breathing through my upper chest, it's gonna move my rib cage and my torso a little bit. We know that's gonna happen in the squat. And if I'm breathing that way in the deadlift, once again, I'm moving my rib cage, which moves my arms. So again, the solution for you is, to the best of your ability, calm down, right? Slow your respiratory breathing. Maybe that means you need a little bit more time before sets. That's totally fine. Go back to some of our basic breathing principles, our 90-90 breathing drill, our alligator breathing, right? Just to show real quick, I'll get feet up on a chair. Maybe this is a gym and the bench. This would be part of my movement prep. This is actually a good way, from an article I just read, interestingly enough too, about slowing that fight or flight response. When I can breathe, put a hand on my stomach, we would cue a different way, but feel that breathing. Coming back to the primary muscles away from the secondary muscles. I really truly like the breathe through a straw cue. I think it helps. Some people like the breathe right cue through the nose. Really, that's just making it mindful for my breath to breathe back into my belly. And maybe not so much for bench press, but for most lifters in the squat and the deadlift, where do we want to breathe, right? Into our brace, into our belt if we're wearing one, into our intra-abdominal pressure. Our alligator breathing drill, of course, as well, sitting here, expanding into the belly, into the floor. I can place a small weight or a kettlebell on my back or have a training partner press down. All of those things are just bringing mindful breath back to your belly. So whether you're in a CrossFit wad, whether you're wearing an elevation mask, or like my buddy, he's too close to me, whether he has to wear a mask, right? If you have that feeling of getting less oxygen in, you need to be mindful of your breath, understanding secondary respiratory muscles move and change the rib cage. That's their job, but it may not be the most efficient way to breathe, and definitely not the most efficient way to breathe for any power lifter or strength athlete. Go fix your squat.